Okay, here is another example that we need to solve. Again, as we discussed earlier, we'll use this equation of the Fourier series, and we'll try to find the three variables, coefficients a0, an, and bn. So let's define the signal first of all. We should see from here the slope of the signal is dy over dt, and that is 6 over 1. So the slope is 6, we multiply that by the time. So this is the equation, and it is valid from 0 to 1. T is equal to 0 to 1. And as we did before, time period is t is equal to 1, and from there we find omega is 2 pi over t is equal to 2 pi. So with this value, now we'll try to find the value of a naught first. This equation, putting the values, t is now 1, so 1 over 1, 0 to t, function is 60, so 60, and integral, you know, of t is t square over 2, we put the limits 0 to 1, and by solving, we find a naught to be 3. Now we'll find an, formula same. So putting the values 2 over 1, ft 60 cos n pi t. So this becomes the equation that we have to integrate. And if we take 6 out, it becomes 12 integral t cos n pi t dt. Now you can see that these are the two variables. So we have to integrate it by parts. And this is the formula that we'll use for integral by parts. You can look into the books. This is one of the simplest ones. There are others also. But we'll use this, that integral of u dv is equal to uv minus integral of v du. So what we need is, we got to define this thing in terms of u and dv. So let's call this as u and the other as v, and then we'll find the value of v from here. So let t be u, and the remaining part we call it dv. So cos 2n pi t dt. Why 2n pi t? Because omega naught was 2 pi. Okay, now if we take the differential of this first part, we get du is equal to dt. So we need a du value here. That is why we differentiated it. And we also had taken this as dv, therefore need to find the value of v. So if we integrate this, we find v is integral of the 2n pi t dt. And by using the integral formula, this it is 1 over 2n pi sine 2n pi t. So now we have got all the elements. So we from this, we'll try to find the value of an. So an will become 12 integral u dv, because this whole thing we have replaced by u dv. So u dv, and then the right hand side uv minus integral v du, and we put the limits from 0 to 1 in both. So this is the limit and this is the integral. Now we plug in the actual values of u and v and du. So from here, u is t, and v we found out to be this value, so we plug in that here. So this is the first part, and we put the limit from 0 to 1. Now in the second part, we take integral of v du. So this was v, So this is V, and du is actually dt, so we put dt. Okay, so we were here, and now let's proceed. So we're just multiplying both with 12, so it becomes 12t, and this term, the first term, and the second term also becomes 12 to n pi n integral of the internal. Now for integral of sine, we'll use this formula, minus 1 over a cos ax. So this we carrying as it is, here 12 over 2 n pi, and the integral of this will be 1 over 2 n pi cos 2 n pi t by this formula. Now we'll simplify. Putting the value of 1 and 0, we get these two terms. This will become 0 because when we multiply 12 by t, or 12 by 0, this term becomes 0. And similarly, we put the limits in the second term. And now this all comes out, and cos 2 n pi minus cos 0 for t, we put 1 and 0. Now we know that the value of sine 0 is 0, and so for any value of n, this will be 0. So if it is like n is 1, then sine 2 pi again 0, sine 3, 4 pi again 0. So this term is 0, this is already 0. And in the second case, it is cos 2 n pi, and we know that the value of cos will be 1 because it is always in terms of 2 pi, so 2 pi or 4 pi or 6 pi, so even terms, so this will become 1, and also we know that cos 0 is equal to 1, so both sides cut, and the final answer is an equals 0. Now we come on to the bn part. This was the formula for bn, exactly same way. By putting the values of ft, 60, and then taking common, 60 multiplied by 2 becomes 12. So 12 sine 2 n pi t dt, and again exactly same way that we did in the previous case. We'll proceed. Yeah, this was missing. So ut, u is equal to 2e and dv now, the second part, so sine 2 n pi t dt. And then we find v by integrating this one. And now we'll use this formula. So it is minus 1 over a cos ax, so minus 1 over 2 n pi cos 2 n pi t. And now we put on the actual value of bn will be 12 integral u dv dt, because from here, this portion we had taken as integral u dv, so u dv multiplied by 12, and then we multiply the right hand side by 12, so this is the value, and then now we'll take the actual values. Just like previous case, the actual value of u is t multiplied by value of v, this value, and minus again v du, or du is equal to dt. So we were here, we again multiply both sides or the in with 12, and exactly in the same manner that we did in the previous case, you go step by step. Now putting the two limits here, and putting the two limits here, we come to these two values. And cos, when even, it will give you 1, this is already 0, and sine is when even it is 0, and sine 0 is also 0. So what is left here is bn is equal to minus 12 over 2n pi, which can be written as minus 6 over n pi. Okay, so if we now go back to get the final equation, we know the values of the coefficients. A naught was 3, A n was 0, and B n was minus 6 over 2 n pi. So putting in the above equations, these values, the equation becomes like this. And this term goes, so this is the equation left, and this can be finally written in this form. So I hope this gives you some idea about the trigonometric Fourier series. In both the examples, you saw that some of the values like an becomes 0, and if we could find it earlier, then we don't have to solve this. So there's a technique of symmetry. We'll see this in the next video, whereby we can find which coefficients we can straight away say that it will be 0. Thank you.